moving the detector around, we can see a dot moving on our screen across the position-sensitive photodiode. So we'll zero out the detector by adjusting the knobs so that the simulated laser beam is right in the center of our position-sensitive photodetector. We'll use the software to adjust the illumination on our sample until our optical microscope is bright enough to see the image. We'll then use our trackball to focus on the tip. And next, we will physically move the optical microscope until the crosshairs on our screen are centered on the backside of the tip. We'll now place the sample on the vacuum chuck of the instrument. My silver paste is dry now, and it goes from the conducting top surface of my sample around the edge into the bottom, so that when placed on the stainless steel chuck, it will make electrical contact to the top of my sample. We then turn the vacuum chuck on and rotate the sample beneath the AFM tip, making sure that the wire for the conducting tip connection to the amplifier does not touch the sample chuck, because that will cause interference in the images. Okay. So having focused the microscope on the AFM tip, we're now going to focus the microscope on the actual surface of our sample. And this is how the microscope actually aligns the tip very near to the surface without actually ramming into it by accident. So we'll start off by clicking on the focus surface icon. So with the in the focus surface mode, moving the trackball will move the sample mount and allow you to position it beneath your AFM tip. And then using the focus mode will actually bring the microscope head closer into the surface. So usually I will observe by eye and get the tip as close to the surface as I reasonably can. And then I will look at the optical image on my screen. So we have two options when actually focusing on our surface. We can choose to focus on the surface itself if we expect it to be dusty or not reflective. However, if you have a clean, transparent surface like we're working with now, it's easier to focus on the reflection of the tip on that surface. So we'll select Focus on Tip Reflection. We'll zoom in slightly on our tip, which is now very blurry, and we'll bring in the microscope head closer to our sample. And we should see the tip reflection come into focus quite nicely, like so. Now, to actually select a spot on the sample that we would like to image, we can switch back to the surface mode, or surface focus mode, and the microscope will adjust itself such that you should be focused on the surface. And we're pretty close. You can see here there's a fleck on the surface. So I might fine-tune my focusing to bring that into good focus. I'll adjust my illumination slightly. And then using the trackball, I'll move around on my surface until I find a region that is of interest to me or just happens to be clean. When that's done, I will then click out of this menu and I will set my software settings to be prepared to engage the tip with the sample. Okay. So the important settings are that you are in the tuna mode, that the Z limit is set at its maximum value. We'll pick a deflection set point that is somewhat larger than our the vertical deflection of our tip as it's zeroed out here. So in this case, our vertical deflection on the tip is minus 0.02 volts. So as a starting deflection set point, I'll select positive 0.3 volts. And then to avoid damage to our soft platinum tip on our hard metal oxide, I will engage with the scan size set to zero so that the tip will come down and sit on a single point rather than coming down and scan. And I will also turn off the slow scan axis. One last check to make sure everything is as it should be. Close the acoustic and electrical noise shielding. Lock it. And then I can leave my static isolation bracelet here. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to engage the tip, and it's going to come down and just sit at a point. Now, the reason that I do it this way is I want to do a series of electrical measurements, and my tip is a very soft metal, mm-hmm. and it's on a very hard abrasive metal oxide. And so if I come down and I start trying to image, I'm basically going to be rubbing my tip off and contaminating it. So, and I will do an array of those. And then once I've run that array of images, or of current voltage curves, I will then back out and actually take the image. And I just set it, and it's now going to do this array of points. Mm-hmm. And so these are the current voltage curves, and basically they just pop up like this. And usually I'll spend a little bit of time adjusting the settings until I get them to where I feel they're appropriate. I usually do an array that's 25 by 25 points.
Okay.
And I choose the spacing such that it's comparable to the area that the AFM tip covers. So my array winds up being 500 nanometers by 500 nanometers. And I can just use the IV curves individually, or I can go and offline later on fit the IV curves and determine electrical properties, which can then be mapped because I know where they were taken. So we'll just scan 500 nanometers squared, and about half a hertz. Go and adjust my gains. I'm just adjusting my gains to try and get what I consider the best overlap between the trace and the retrace of the tip without introducing too much noise. I can set my microscope to start at the top of the image and begin obtaining data. The left-hand side represents topography or height, and the right-hand side represents a current with, in this case, black being more current and the reddish-brown representing zero current.